whoever the guy was, pulled up and made some comments to her from his car.
A warning tonight about an attempted kidnapping of a child. It happened in broad daylight as she was walking to school.
A teenage girl suddenly stalked by a stranger. Good evening to you. I'm Sheree Palella.
And I'm Mike Dardis. A close call for her because she says the man grabbed her by the hair and tried to pull her into his car. WLWT News 5's John London just got back from over the Rhine where it all started. John?
Yeah, some pretty frightening moments, Mike, just before 9 this morning. The girl had just started up the long Ravine Street hill when a gray or tan four-door Plymouth slowed, turned around, and started trailing her.
The girl got away right around here towards the top of Ravine Street, several long uphill blocks from where the ordeal started.
She said she kicked him or either stepped on his foot real hard and punched him in his face, and I guess that's when he let go.
Although she normally takes the bus, the 14-year-old was walking to her school, Hughes High. Right here at the base of Ravine, she told police a car heading downhill went past her and made a U-turn at Central Parkway. Police say the man, described as in his 50s, told her how pretty she was and motioned for her to come closer. Her uncle tells us she kept walking but was easily tracked up the hill. Then the man opened the driver's side door.
She says he told her, I gave you compliments and, you know, told you you look nice and everything and you ignoring me. And he supposedly grabbed her by her hair, I guess, and that's when she started fighting him.
Once she broke loose, she saw him turn left on McMillan, ran to Hughes, and headed straight for the school resource officer, who praised her for the solid descriptions of both the suspect and the vehicle. People in the area around Hughes were largely unaware about it.
This morning, really?
We told Faith McGillivray that the girl was uninjured.
I'm so pleased, yeah.
That's kind of shocking when you told me that story right now. I mean, you rarely hear those kind of stories, I feel like.
It can get fairly isolated at times along the Ravine Street Hill. It was when we were there a few hours after it happened, around 8:45. But at that time...
Well, she says people were seeing this and, like, nobody interfered.
Now, the girl and her mother have been with police this afternoon to try and identify a suspect. Police have not confirmed anything yet to us about whether an arrest in this case has been made. Mike?
John, police say that the girl described the attacker as a 6-foot-tall white man in his 50s, about 170 pounds, brown hair, blue eyes. She was able to provide them with information about the license plate number as well. And